Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is a flail test. So, what a flail test is? A flail test occurs when a segment of the rib cage breaks under extreme pressure and stress and becomes detached from the rest of the chest wall. It is usually defined as at least 2 fractures per rib in at least 3 or more days. So it will produce a free segment of the ribs inside the chest wall. So what is the most common cause of this flail test? It is a vehicle accident. Second most common cause is fall, especially in case of elderly population. And the third most common cause is blunt trauma in children, especially those with a genetic condition, for example, osteogenesis imperfecta, in which the bone is abnormally formed and very weak and prone to fracture. So what's going on in flail chest? As we all know that during normal inspiration, the diaphragm contracts and the intercostal muscles pull the ribcage out. So the pressure in the thorax decreases below the atmospheric pressure and the air rushes in through the trachea. But the flail segment will be pulled in with the decrease in the pressure while the rest of the ribcage is expands. So there is a opposite movement which occurs in the patient. During normal expiration, the diaphragm and the intercostal muscle relax. So there is increase in the internal pressure, allowing the abdominal organ to pull the air upward and out of the thorax. But again, in case of flail chest, the flail segment will also be pulled out. While the rest of the ribcage is contracting, the flail segment is pulling out. So there also opposite movement. There is 2 type of flail chest, external flail and the lateral flail. But because of this flail segment, there is opposite movement in the chest wall, which is called paradoxical movement. Due to this paradoxical movement, there is paradoxical breathing, because since the flail segment moves in an opposite direction to the rest of the chest wall, so there is opposite movement and opposite breathing, paradoxical breathing. What is implications of the flail test? There can be pulmonary contusion, mediastinal flutters, pneumothorax, hemothorax, and pain. All of these can lead to respiratory failure. So how can we diagnose this condition? Clinically, you can see for the bruises in the chest, paradoxical movement in the chest. If there is any paradoxical movement in the chest wall is present, it is highly suggestive that there is a flail segment present. You can also diagnose it by chest X-ray or CT. So how can we manage these patients? Analgesia is the mainstay of the treatment in these patients. Other things which we can use for the management is intubation or ventilation, chest tube insertion, rib fracture fixation. As I have already told you that the analgesia is the mainstay of the treatment in patient with a flail chest, we can use opioid analgesics, NSAIDs, thoracic or high lumbar epidural with or without opioid additives, posterior rib blocks, and instillation of local analgesia into the pleural space through the ICD. If patient needed, we can intubate him for the ventilation, though it is rarely indicated, but in some situation it has to be done. It is indicated for hypoxia due to pulmonary contusion. In case of flail chest, we can use a double lumen tracheal tube, and each lumen of which will be connected to a different ventilator. It is because in case of flail chest, each lung may require drastically different pressure and flow to adequately ventilate. Other things which we can use is chest tube insertion. It is generally due to treat hemothorax and pneumothorax, which is generally associated in patient in case of flail chest. Rib fracture fixation is usually not required. It is preferred choice before intubating the patient or ventilate the patient. Another mainstay of the treatment is physiotherapy. It is required to add better drainage of the secretion, to rebuild the musculature, and to reposition the chest wall. We can use cuffing exercise, resistant exercise, and trunk exercises. For rehabilitation of the patient, 12-week outpatient program for at least 3 days a week is needed. Patient should be seen for 30 to 45 minutes a day after a 5 to 10 minutes warm-up session. After discharging the patient should be given an exercise regime to be performed at home. Mortality rate of the flail, what is the outcome of the flail chest? Mortality rate of the flail chest ranges from the 10 to 25% patient, and ventilation has a little effect on the outcome. Mainstay is analgesia and physiotherapy and observation. So this is about flail chest. Thank you.